that had in the game?
It just comes down to hustling. Comes down to who wants it, and you know, we take pride in being physical. So, you know, first person to hit the deck is gonna come up with it, and that's the mindset we have.
A lot of talk in the last 24 hours is about you and Russ together. A lot of it off the court. On the court, what makes you guys good together?
I think it's the best of both worlds. Russ is one of the most explosive, athletic guys, and I'm the opposite of that. Just, you know, my game is more smooth, so we complement each other very well. I think we both can play off one another. I can attack and set him up, and as you see, he does it vice versa. So we just have fun. We have fun. We enjoy playing with one another. It's just fun out there being alongside him.
What was your favorite play tonight? The steal you made of Beal and then the bounce pass?
Absolutely. He got to start, you know, doing more tricks on the fastball. I'm getting tired of his little normal dunks. He's too athletic to be doing these simple dunks.
Well, you said about a month ago this team was starting to play better, but the wins weren't showing up.
Right.
And they started to show up. What's the difference? Is the shot just going in?
I think everything is starting to click from defense to offense. You know, we're getting out in transition. We're getting stops. But I think when teams go on runs throughout the game, we do a great job of just countering or, you know, still keeping our pace up. You know, where we struggle down the stretch in past games, where we weren't winning, it's because we, you know, when teams make a run, you know, we try to make home run plays right off the bat. I just think we stay steady. We stay steady throughout the game. And, there's a trust factor. We're all on the same page, and we trust one another. Yeah.
Paul, if there is one thing you really love to see during the past six games, what would that be?
During the past six games?
Yes, during this winning streak.
What are you asking?
If there is one thing you really love to see from this past six games.
Carrying over into the next couple games?
Yeah, those winning streak.
That's winning. That's you know, we've been struggling. We've been playing really well, but struggling to win games before this six-game win streak. So just us coming out with victories and the way we've done them. We've had some grindouts. We've had some blowouts. We've been able to win games from, you know, great competitors to, you know, teams on paper we should beat. So I think we're moving in the right direction in that aspect.
Paul, what's the discussion like with Billy and the coaching staff as to whether or not you start the second quarter or Melo starts the second quarter? Because we've seen that before times this year, but you know, we've seen Billy also like tonight go with like the all bench units to start the second quarter.
Yeah, it's just, you know, Billy just trying to find it, I guess, in moments throughout the game where all three of us can get some rest. And our second unit's been playing phenomenal. I think the beauty in it is that group is starting to get chemistry. They're starting to play at a high level. They're starting to, you know, keep the firepower out there when we're on the bench, which is great. It's great to get us three off the floor at times and get us some rest. But, you know, again, still having that unit out there that's going to put pressure on the other team.
Well, you made a joke earlier this year about how, like, trying to keep up with Russell, your feet get all scrambled and you can't do it. When Russ is on that run in the fourth quarter and he's just going at the hoop every single time, no matter where he is, like, is that what you had in mind when you were talking about that?
Yeah. You know, I heard Melo, and there's no way you can catch up to that. And you know, Russ is a great finisher. You know, there's nobody that can stand in front of him or keep up with him. When he's locked in, you know, that's immediately where I turn my mindset to playing defense. Save that energy of running down there and try to get another stop for Russ to get us out and going. You know, he's just one of a kind in the transition and fast break that, you know, is unmatched. Nobody can keep up with him.
Is he the fastest guy in the league?
Absolutely, with or without the ball.
What was your thoughts on city jerseys that you guys did?
I love them. Really, really, really nice jersey. You know, it's great to have a little switch up, a little change up. But, you know, glad Nike was able to pull that together. We were supposed to wear those a long time ago, but happy they pulled it.
you've talked a lot about Terrence Ferguson and kind of some of the things that have brought some memories back from you.
Mm-hmm.
Seems like a guy that doesn't have a whole lot of fear, especially, you know, big moments tonight. He just launched in fire. Yeah, what would you think about just kind of
he's a confident kid. Again, I see myself all over for, you know, it was my rookie year. And I was trying to find my way, figure out my way in the league. He's very talented, very skilled, very confident, you know, and it's great to plug him in and not lose anything on the offensive end or defensive end.
You guys giving Russ crap because he was last on that All-Star list?
No, it was in alphabetical order. It was in alphabetical order. You know, it was in alphabetical order. You know, LeBron loves Russ, so I doubt he would pick Russ last.
Thanks, BG.